way up in the far north country, in a place called Araho. That's where I left my brother. This story you shall know. We were best pals since childhood. Oft times he'd rode by my side. I'll tell you first how he lived, boys, then I'll tell you how he died. He was just a kid, boys, I remember how we cried. I was only 17, he 10 when mother died. He grew up to be a cowboy, could ride and rope with the best. But he got in with the evil companions in the fur trapping business out west. One day he returned from his trap line. He wasn't surprised when he saw a red coat and a ranger in the doorway. He knew he had broken the law. In a cabin in Canada's Rockies, where there's nothing but beauty and peace, he took the life of that ranger and a Canadian mounted police. The captain then called me before him, said, lad, you're not to blame. Before that ranger died, son, he mentioned your young brother's name. I hope that he isn't guilty, but I'll get him if I can. I'll leave you with these orders. The Mounties get their man. For 3 long months we sought him. We found and lost his trail. He finally left a letter saying he'd never land in jail. It seemed my wishing was hopeless. I felt heartbroken and blue. By the words of that poor dying ranger, it seems we're coming back true. At last we followed his trail. From footprints we found in snow, they led to a little log cabin not far from the old Araho. We told him that he was surrounded. His answer to us was in lead. Few shots rang out in the darkness. The last man, my brother, was dead. We buried him there by the cabin, a soul that ne'er could be saved. Oh, mother, I ask your forgiveness for sending the boy to the grave. Oh, God, oh, Father in heaven, I thank you each night that she's there. You spared her all heartaches and sorrows. You've answered this young Mountie's prayer.